Hello, this is the Provoked Prawn, and this is the Corsair RM750. This is a modular power supply unit, and in this video, I'm going to be talking to you about how to install this PSU, where you connect the various cables, and how to set it up in your case to make sure everything's running nicely. So I'm going to show you what's included in the box and talk to you about the various cables that you need to use, where to plug them in, and demonstrate inside and outside the case to make your life a little bit easier and show what's what. Now, obviously, I am from England, so I have a British plug included in my box. You may get a different power cable plug, so don't panic if yours is different, depending on your mains power supply. But you should also get a nice bag chocked full of cables and a variety of different ones, some cable ties and some screws, and I'll show you the logic for those later on. But for the moment, I'm just going to unbox the power supply unit and show you what's what there, and also obviously get all the cables out. There are a lot of cables here which might seem intimidating. You might not need them all, so don't panic if you have any left over by the end. I will show you what you need to connect up, and this will vary depending on your motherboard and your graphics card as well, so it's worth bearing that in mind. And if you're not sure on the wattage of power supply unit that you need, be sure to check out the link in the description to the PSU calculator, which allows you to work out the levels of PSU and make sure you actually have the right size. This is a 750 watt, should be enough for my system, but you need to make sure that your components included in your machine, that you have the right power supply in order to power them, so it's pretty important. But I'm assuming that you have that knowledge already, so here we're going to talk about what you do with this one. So this is a modular power supply unit, which means that you only need to plug in the cables you need, which is obviously great for cable management, makes life a lot easier. On the power supply unit, you'll find various markings for what cables go where, and on the cables themselves, you'll also find markings for which cable is what and where they plug in, essentially. That makes your life fairly straightforward. So this large one, this is the chunkiest one, and quite possibly the most important one you'll plug in. This is the 24-pin power supply unit cable, and you can see it plugs in on the top right. It's actually split into two, but it plugs in where the motherboard markings are. And you can't get this the wrong way around, because there's a clip on top which clicks into the little hole above all the different pins. So there are two parts to this, and obviously on the other end you have one single connection with the 24 pins, but you notice on the power supply end it's split. Now I'm going to show you where to plug it in on the motherboard. So this obviously is my motherboard cell, but usually on the right hand side, roughly in the middle, is where you'll find the same connection. You wouldn't plug this in outside the case normally. I'm just demonstrating it where it is because it's cleaner view for you to see here. And you can see that plugs in. It can be a little bit fiddly, and it's also very difficult to get back off again, worth bearing in mind. But I just wanted to show how to do it now. This is inside the Corsair 4000D airflow, and you can see things are a little bit tighter once you've actually run the cables from the rear of the case, which I'll show you later on. But you can manipulate this cable around. It is a little bit fiddly and not that neat, so you might want to consider cable extensions or some fancier cables, but the standard cables are pretty flexible once you've got the hang of it. Now you'll also find some pretty important CPU cables. These also plug into the top of the motherboard to make sure that your motherboard has enough power for the CPU. Again, you'll find markings on the cables that say they're CPU, and also on the power supply unit, if you look closely, you'll see ports with CPU markings on them. You should find three cables in the bag which have the same labeling, so all three of them are CPU. And you can see PCIe/CPU markings on the bottom right, so you can plug in two of them there. And if you need a third one, you'll notice on the top left next to the SATA PATA ones, there's also another PCIe/CPU connection up there. And also on the bottom right, where I've already plugged in those two, there's another two next to that which also will potentially take them. So you have a variety of places to plug these in. Now this is important. Usually you'll only find two 8-pin power cables that will run at the back of your case, and you need to run them up to the top, and usually on the left hand side, or on the right in this case, you're looking at it from the rear. So run them round to the back, tie them up, tidy them up, and get them ready for when you've installed the motherboard and put that into place. So here you can see the final point. Now this motherboard requires 3 8-pin CPU power connections. That's fairly unusual, but just be sure to check your motherboard and your motherboard manual to see which ones you need to plug in and where they are. Sometimes you might find These are at the bottom of the motherboard, for example, so it's worth bearing that in mind. But here you can see, again, outside the case, I'm plugging them into the motherboard just to demonstrate where they go. Again, you can't get this wrong as long as you use the cables that are marked CPU and you plug them into the CPU part of the power supply unit. You then plug them into the top of the motherboard and they will fit, because it's impossible to plug these in incorrectly. But just don't confuse them with the PCIe cables, which are for a different use, which I'll show you in a second. So again, that's the setup for that, but again, you would do it when it's in the case. You'll see it's a lot more complicated, and this will vary depending on your case. But in this case, for example, it's important to plug these cables in before you mount any radiators to the top of the case or any fans, because if you get to that stage, you'll find that it's very fiddly and it's quite difficult to get your hand behind the radiator or underneath the fans in order to manipulate the cables into the motherboard, which can be a pain. This will vary depending on your case, but also the size of the motherboard. So this is an E80X motherboard, so it's quite a large one, takes up a lot of room in a smaller case, which makes it a little bit more difficult. Something to bear in mind just when you're going through the installation process and the build. If you're interested, I've done a build guide on this case in a variety of different setups, and I'll link to those videos in the description so you can find out more on how that works. But just demonstrating the process here, and it's roughly the same. As I said, usually most motherboards will just have two 8-pin CPU connections at the top and then a 24-pin on the right-hand side. So that is the motherboard power setup, and that's fairly straightforward. The next step is to set up the rest of the parts for your build. The next cable that we're going to be using here is the SATA connection. So this is a flat power connection and it's daisy chainable. So you'll see that at one end you have that connection that you've already seen plugged into the power supply unit. And then throughout the rest of the cable you have a number of other flat clips. This is used for basically other connections with a SATA logic. So you can see it plugs in on the top left, and then it will control things like fan control boxes. So you can see here Corsair's Commander Core or Commander Pro as a fan controller. You can basically connect up the flat connector up to your power supply unit that way, and it's daisy chainable, so you can actually connect multiple devices to the same cable. So this will be powering lots of fans in the case, but you can also plug in other things. So another example of something you might connect up SATA power to is a hard disk drive. So if you have a platter hard disk drive or a 2.5 inch SSD, those require the same sort of power. Again, the flat power connector, and you'll find this has an L shape to it, so it's actually difficult slash impossible to plug it in the wrong way around because of the way that sits. But here you can see I've plugged it in when it's in the case, and you'll see that daisy chainable effect with multiple cables coming out of it. So a bit further on into the build, now we've got both the fan controller and the hard disk drive plugged into the same cable. So you don't need multiple SATA cables if you're plugging in multiple devices. This makes things a little bit neater and makes life a little bit easier when you're going through the build process. So just bear that in mind depending on what you're plugging in. Now the next one, which is very important if you're a PC gamer, is the PCIe connection. This will give you the power for your graphics card. Again, you'll find the markings on the power supply unit for this. I'm using that one in the top left, but there's also one where my thumb is. It has that marking for PCIe slash CPU, so depending on which connections you're using and how many you need. So in this instance, I'm using a NVIDIA Founders Edition card. This is a 3060 Ti, and that has a single connection on it. It also has that adapter that you'll find with a Founders Edition card. So you need that, and then you need the single 8-pin connection and PCIe. Again, make sure this is the PCIe labeled cable, and this end of it plugs in there. Now what you'll find is this cable's split into two parts. Obviously you then have an extra part that you don't need, but you might find that you have a larger, more power hungry graphics card. So here is the Gigabyte Overclock Vision graphics card. This is a 3090 and actually requires two of those connections. Now these are slightly different power cables, but the logic is the same. These are the premium individually sleeved power supply unit cables from Corsair, which are an additional purchase. They're separate, but you can see they're nicer looking cables and they're a bit easier to make look snazzy. And here I'm plugging in two lots of 8-pin connections. It's the same logic, it's the same set up at the other end. You plug them into the power supply unit, but then you have two connections to plug into your graphics card for the more hungry graphics card. You might also find sometimes you have the need for three 8-pin power connections, and you will find the cables for this in the box. So just find another spare PCIe connection on your PSU and plug it in there. The next one is the PATA. Now, this is fairly unusual, but again, look for those SATA / PATA markings, and this will be required for other accessories, things like a liquid cooling pump. So you can see this is a liquid cooling pump / reservoir combo, and on the bottom of that is this connection, which fairly stands out as being quite unique from the others, quite a chunky thing and a little bit fiddly, but this requires that power, so make sure you plug those in. So we've got most of that set up now, and I would recommend, highly recommend, plugging in all the cables that you're going to need before you try installing the power supply unit in your case. This is especially important if you have a smaller case that you're building in, you don't have a full tower, because it makes it much, much easier to manipulate all those cables around inside the build rather than having to wedge your hand in a tiny gap in order to plug them in, where you won't be able to see what cables plug in where. So it makes life easier just to plug in all the cables beforehand and then seat and set up the power supply unit and screw it into place. Also note, when you're going about the installation process, that you want to make sure the fan on the power supply unit has access to a port. So in this case, it's facing downwards because that bottom fan sucks in cold air into the power supply unit to keep it cool and then exhausts the hot air through the back where your power cable plugs into it. So just bear that in mind during the build. It's going to vary on a case-by-case basis, but it usually faces the bottom. Once that's done, obviously I've done this in a bit of a weird order, but I wanted to demonstrate the logic for it and to show where the cables go, so hopefully it's been a bit clear. But then plugging that all in and then screwing it in with the four screws included, and you'll find the little points on the back of the case where these will screw into the holes, and then obviously use all those to secure it into place, and then run the cables through the various points as I showed you at the back, and plug them into those various sockets. And there you have it. That is the finished product. You are now away. Obviously, then plug in the extra cable to the mains and turn it on. And job done. This has been the Provoked Prawn. Check out the video links in the description for more. Thanks for watching. This has been the Provoked Prawn. Hope you found this video useful, interesting, hilarious, or otherwise. Take a look at these other videos that I think you might find interesting as well. And have a look at the description for links and other information you might find useful. Click that join button to see the benefits of being a member of my YouTube channel. And most importantly, have a great life.